You all, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, this evening time as we gather in our homes as individuals and families and worship together, may we invite God's presence. Let us look to God as we begin this worship. Oh, clap your hands, all your peoples, shout to God with the voice of triumph, for the Lord Most High is awesome. He is a great king over all the earth. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, wonderful Heavenly Father, on this day of worship, we come to you with hearts filled with uncertainties, with hearts filled with fear, as the epidemic, the pandemic, corona, is prevalent across the globe. Gracious God, we are your people, we are called by you. We know that you are the Creator God who created the heavens and the earth and that is all in it. You are the giver of life. God, at this time, as we worship and pray in one accord, though we are separated, we are apart by space, but we know that we are one in heart. And we worship you with one heart. Gracious God, we seek your presence. Gracious God, we invoke your presence to be with us, to be among us, among our families, in the church as we worship. We commit the servant who is going to preach to us this evening, that our hearts may be comforted through your comforting words. We submit to you each of those dear ones who are worshiping together with us. We pray this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. This evening for meditation, the text is taken from Exodus chapter 33, verses 7 to 11. Exodus chapter 33, verses 7 to 11. Moses took his tent and pitched it outside the camp, far from the camp, and called it the Tabernacle of Meeting. And it came to pass that everyone who sought the Lord went out to the Tabernacle of Meeting, which was outside the camp. So it was, whenever Moses went out to Tabernacle, that all the people rose and each man stood at his tent door and watched Moses until he had gone into the Tabernacle. And it came to pass, when Moses entered the tabernacle, that the pillar of cloud descended and stood at the door of the tabernacle, and the Lord talked with Moses. All the people saw the pillar of cloud standing at the tabernacle door, and all the people rose and worshipped, each man in his tent door. So the Lord spoke to Moses face to face, as a man speaks to his friend, and he would return to the camp. But his servant Joshua, the son of Nun, a young man, did not depart from the tabernacle. May the Lord bless these words in our midst. Our pastor, Reverend Dr. Peter Paul Shetty, would be bringing to us the message with the theme, The Glory of God's Presence. The glory of God's presence, as we prepare our hearts to listen to the word of God. Let us join in singing, Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my
Very good evening, church. We are very glad to be here as God has brought us to be in a different places but connect together in His presence. We are so glad and happy. We have spent throughout the day spending our lives in the presence of the Lord. We are very glad and want to thank the Lord for this blessed opportunity through Standing Committee, Centenary Baptist Church, Secunderabad has made it possible that we all together may praise His holy name and look unto Him and ask His divine presence to work through us. This evening, it is going to be a different thing now, and you're going to experience God's divine blessings. And this evening, as we have titled it as the God's glorious presence, God's glorious presence. And we're going to understand a few things from the past messages where the Lord was speaking to us about the kingdom of God, God's kingdom. God has been working on, ruling on into our lives that we can be so effective, powerful, working on for Him, and He can rule in through our lives. So this evening, you are here, and we bow down before Him and ask the Lord to strengthen us, that God can speak to us. And we ask the Lord to give us that spirit and mind that we can experience His divine power in this time of calamity, where things are just shaken, where we see in the book of Acts, where the apostles, they were making the world upside down with the powerful word of God. And today the world is being shaken with some kind of a sickness that is prevailing us. And we want you, every one of us, the one who are, we took together as we are looking unto the Lord and asking the Lord to strengthen us, that we can bring down that fear, that we can remove the things from our life, and God can bring glory and honor to our lives. Let's to the Lord in prayer that God can speak to us. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we praise You, we adore Your holy name at this moment. We want You to strengthen us as the dear ones, as hearing Thy word, as we listen to Your voice, O God. We want Your Spirit of God to strengthen us, speak to us, and we want You to completely take control of our time. Oh Lord, let Your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. So this evening, as we are here to praise and to worship God, and we find this one as a unique time of our history in our lives. And we have not done that before, but God is making us possible that we can connect to Him. And this is our time together to understand that God's glorious presence, His presence is there in us, in our midst. Bible is saying in Matthew's Gospel chapter 18 verse 20, where two or three gathered in My name, I am there in their midst. And this evening, God is there in our midst as we are looking unto the Lord and asking His Holy Spirit of God to speak to us. And He is going to work through us. And His presence, it's so powerful, it's so wonderful. And we want His presence to captivate our lives and remove all the things that the enemy is trying to disturb us. And God has given us that opportunity that we can connect to Him and bring glory and honor to His name. Where this evening we are talking about the glory of His presence, the God's glorious presence. The word glory, where we find in Hebrew, is kabod, which means as a splendor, as a honor. In Exodus chapter 33 verse 19, we see where Moses was asking God, and God was telling Moses, I'm going to pass through by, and I'm going to do that. And we see in verse number 19, that He has been so graciously working on, helping on, and looking into, and seeing, helping us to understand that His goodness, the word goodness, where we find it as tobo, where it's a beauty, where the glory of God's presence, when it is filled with full of holiness and brilliance of beauty. His holiness filling us. His holiness filling us with the brilliant of beauty that is going to transform the things. And His presence has made so many things, made it possible. From Genesis onwards, we are going to look into the things and understand that God is going to work through us and give that divine power and authority pumping out of our lives, and He is going to work through us. It is what God is saying, that I will make all my goodness, Exodus chapter 33 verse 19, I will make all my goodness pass before thee, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and I will be gracious to you, to whom I will be gracious, and I will show mercy on whom I will show mercy. God is going to make His goodness pass through, His beauty, His love, His divineness is going to pass through our lives. This evening, as we look unto God and ask the Lord to strengthen us, to look unto His presence to work through us, and His divine glory, His presence to be with us, through us. Let's talk about a few examples from the scriptures and understand about His presence. What happened? How things have changed by His presence? In the Garden of Eden, the book of Genesis, let's turn to Genesis chapter 3 verse 8, where we understand about His presence in the Garden of Eden. Genesis chapter 3 verses 8 to 10, where we understand about His divine attributes have been revealed, where His presence is so powerful. Verse number 8, and they heard the voice of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. Number one, where we find when His presence, He comes with the glory in the Garden of Eden, and His presence had made them to hide, run away. And they were hiding behind the trees. We all know the story and the incident, what happened in the Garden of Eden. And it is clearly understood by us that His presence of His power that made them to be running away from His presence, because He's so powerful. He's so powerful that His presence made them to be distancing themselves and hiding themselves, because they have done something which is God doesn't want them to do. And they have done it. God said that don't eat this fruit. The fruit that is going to give you knowledge of good and evil. Don't eat that. They began to work on in the wrong way, disobeying God. They ate the fruit and they could end up in saying that they have been hiding from the presence of God. His presence was so powerful that it made them to distance from God. Sometimes when He wants to walk through us, He wants to talk to us, He wants to move through us, and He is asking us to come back to Him, and He's asking, where are you this evening? God is asking the same question. Where are you now? How is your spiritual life? Are you running away? Are you hiding? Come back. His presence has a fellowship power. His presence is so powerful that it will make you to connect to Him back. So this evening He's saying, you come back to me, I need to talk to you. And it's an opportunity that God has given you and to me to come back to Him and say, Lord, I want your presence to work through me. In the Garden of Eden, He is just longing to have fellowship with you. This evening He has made it possible that you are here, and He wants to work through you. Secondly, we find a wonderful illustration and a word from Genesis chapter 20. Genesis chapter 20, verse number 7, from the life of Abraham. From the life of Abraham, Genesis chapter 20, verse 7. Now therefore, restore the man his wife, and he is a prophet, and he shall pray for thee, and thou shalt live, and if thou restore her not, know that thou wilt surely die, and all that there are thine. Here we talk about God's divine presence in the life of Abraham and Abimelech. The story of Abimelech, we all know that in the night God visited him and said, you restore the things. You go back. The power of his presence will bring favor to his people. His presence, his glorious presence that made Adam and Eve think about and rectify their love towards God and come back, and God sheltered them. Here we see the presence of God which made Abraham a prophet. Abraham to come back to God and bless Abimelech. And he prayed for Abimelech, verse number 17. So Abraham prayed unto God, and God healed Abimelech and his wife and his maidservants, and they bare children. So God blocked the children. Why? Because there was something that he need to understand, that God was with Abraham. God is so powerful. He is so unique. His presence is so powerful. And his presence will make things happen. This evening God is asking us to come back to him, that his presence, by his presence we can gain favor. It is by him alone we have favor. Verse chapter 21, verse number 22, we see then this. And it came to pass the time that Abimelech and Phinehas, the chief captain of his host, spoke unto Abraham and saying, God is with thee in all that thou doest. Everything, whatever you do, God is with you, and you are successful. And his presence, his glorious presence, that will make our lives successful. And wherever we go around, whoever we talk, and God is going to work through us. Abimelech, he could understand that God was with Abraham. This evening, God wants to be with you. God wants to work through us. And it's an opportunity for us to come back to him and say, Lord, I want you to function through me. Lord, I want you to work through me. Genesis chapter 26, one more thing we will look into. Genesis chapter 26, verses 1 to 5, we have a similar story where God wants us to understand from the life of Isaac. And there was a famine in the land beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto Abimelech, king of Philistines, unto Gerar. And the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down to Egypt, dwell in the land which I shall tell thee. Sojourn in the land in that I were with thee, and will bless thee, for unto thee and unto thy seed I will give all these countries, and I will perform the oath which I swore unto Abraham thy father, and I will make thee the stars of heaven, and I will give unto thy seed all the countries, and in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. We see God's presence brings that complete fulfillment of his favor of blessings. God wants to work through us and bring forth that abundant blessings through us. This evening, it's an opportunity for us to think back and say, Lord, I need your presence. Lord, I need your divine presence to work through me, wherein we can have that blessing growing through. Wherever you go, whatever you do, his blessing, his power, his divine protecting hand is along with you. You can conquer things. You can achieve things because his presence is there. In order to have his presence, we need to do one thing. That's what verse number 5 it says. Genesis chapter 26, verse number 5. Because that Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge, my commandments, my statutes, and my laws. And that is what God is telling to us, that we need to obey his voice, keep his charge, his commandments, his statutes, and his laws. We need to keep all these things in order to have his presence dwell in us, in order to have his presence moving through us, and all the success and happiness God wants you and I to experience. It is only by our obedience, his fulfilling power, that will enable us. This evening, it's an opportunity for us to have the greater blessings in obedience to God. We need to have that greater blessings. Yes, my dear friend, my dear in the Lord, you are here listening His voice. You have been selected to be here this evening. And it is an opportunity for you and to us, to every one of us, that we need to come back to His presence. The glorious presence will make us to retrieve our life, to check on, as Adam was given opportunity to check on things. Secondly, He has given an opportunity, a favored power to get healing and life. And thirdly, we understand that it is a fulfilling power for greater blessings. He wants to fulfill in through us when we obey God. He wants to be in a higher level of our spiritual standards. You need to obey God. We need to obey God. His voice, it is very still, it is direct, and it is from the Word, and it is from your heart. The God, the Lord is speaking to you. The Spirit of God is speaking to you. It's an opportunity for us coming back to Him and to experience that. The Lord is with us. That's what we see. Verse number 28, Genesis chapter 26, verse number 28. And they said, we saw certainly that the Lord was with thee, and we said, let there be an oath between us, even between us, you and me, and let us make a covenant with thee. They are saying that we saw certainly the Lord was with thee. God's presence is with you. When God's presence is with us, and we have just time, the whole week you have time, go through all the scriptures once again and read on this wonderful incident of how the Lord was working through Isaac. This evening, it's an opportunity for us to check back again and say, Lord, I need your glorious presence. Lord, I need your glorious presence, that wherein I can be a blessing to wherever, whomever I go around, wherever I go around, I can be a blessing. We need God's presence to be with us. It is by obedience to His voice. It is by His divine power and authority that we carry on. And we say, Lord, I want you to work through me. I want to hear your voice. I want to be obedient to your commandments, status, and your law, and your scripture. And God is going to work on. A wonderful thing, thought we understand from Joshua. Let's turn to the book of Joshua, chapter 1, where we understand about from the life of Joshua, where Moses, a dear man of God, has been called by God. And Joshua has been given encouraging words from the Lord, and is saying, verses 5 onwards, we see, there shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, not forsake thee. He is giving Joshua an opportunity and saying that I'm going to give you the power to fight over the enemies. He has given the power of fellowship. He has given a favored power to heal and life. He has given that power of fulfilling of greater blessings by obedience. And He's now helping us to understand, fourthly, fighting the power of the enemy. To fight over the enemy, to resist the enemy, to overcome. Verse number 5, we see once again, there shall not be any man be able to stand before thee in all the days of thy life, to multiply as the stars of heaven. The Lord, and is saying, verses 5 onwards, we see, is now helping us to understand, fourthly, fighting the power of the enemy, to fight over the enemy, to resist the enemy, to overcome. Verse number 5, we see once again, there shall not be any man be able to stand before thee in all the days of thy life. And as I was with Moses, I will be with you. I'm going to be with you. His glorious presence, when it is there with you and with us, and we are going to be victorious people. We are going to be successful. We are going to be people encouraging others, accomplishing things which you have not planned. And God is going to make it possible to bring glory and honor to His name. This evening, It is an opportunity for His presence to come down into our life. And He's there in our midst as you're listening. His presence is always working through us. The moment you are saved, the Holy Spirit of God has been sealed in our heart. He is dwelling from the moment you are being saved. And you are daily going on, day by day, renewing yourself from glory unto glory, step on by step, looking unto the cross of Calvary, looking unto the things above, that we can have the image of Jesus Christ formed in us. That is what Jesus is saying. That is what the challenge of our Christian life following Jesus, that we need to have the mind and heart and our lifestyle reflecting the love of Jesus through our lives. This evening, you have an opportunity to come back to Jesus and say, Lord, I want your presence. I want your glory to shine through me, wherein I can experience that fellowship, that I can come out of that darkness, that I can come out of that weakness, I can come out of that particular bondage that I've been binded around, that I can come back to you, because your presence is always awaiting. That I can have the favor, that I can pray for people, that I can have that love of Jesus giving life to others, transforming others' lives, and that I can experience a greater blessing, resisting the enemy. The enemy is always there in our life, Christian life. He is there ever ready. I want to do something, we want to do something we are not able to do, and what we want to do we are not able to do. That is the struggle that is we are going through. In Romans chapter 7, we see whether day and night we have that struggle, but still we are being renewed, refined by the divine power of the Holy Spirit and by the fire of the heavenlies, who is working through us. He's refining us, giving and helping us to have that divine work to happen, that Christ may be formed in us, that His character may be developed, that we can be into perfection, into fullness of His divine power and His body of Jesus Christ. We have one more incident happened in Judges of His presence. His presence was so powerful. Judges chapter 6. Judges chapter 6, where we find a beautiful incident in the life of Gideon. Chapter 6 verses 12 onwards to 14 and verse 21. We are going to read it. And verse number 12. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. He says that the Lord is with thee. The Lord is with you. This evening God is with you. You are worried about situation. You are worried about so many things. But His presence is with you. Right now as you are listening, His presence is with you, and He wants to give you that strength, that power and energy from you. Verse number 21, and then the angel of the Lord put forth an end of the staff that was in his hand, and touched the flesh and unleavened cakes, and there arose up fire out of the rock and consumed the flesh and unleavened cakes. Then the angel of the Lord departed out of his sight. We find here where Gideon was asking the angel of the Lord, if you are really working through me, show me a sign. Then the angel of the Lord said, okay, bring down, pick it, keep it on the rock. And the flesh and unleavened cakes were kept, and the angel of the Lord touched, and the fire ignited out of the rock. The fire ignited out of the rock. His presence will ignite fire out of your life, where there is deadness, where there is no nothing, where is impossibilities thinking on your coming into your mind. The impossibilities are going to go away, and God is going to ignite that fire out of that rock. There is a divine presence, a glorious presence of the Lord. God is a supernatural God. He works wondrous things. He works through you. You may be thinking, you may be calculating things, but God works beyond our calculation. God works beyond our imagination. God works beyond our limited knowledge. This evening, God is saying, I'm going to do it possible. I'm going to make it possible. I'm going to work through. And the fire igniting power of Jesus, He is going to work through us. He asked us, show me a sign. He is going to transform. His glorious presence in the Garden of Eden brought the fellowship. In the life of Abraham, Abimelech, his presence made it clear that he has that healing and life flowing through. And in the life of Isaac, he fulfilled the greater blessing that I'm going to make your generations to generations. I'm going to make it as the stars of heaven. And I'm going to bless you and give you mercy. And we find in Joshua, in the life of Joshua, he given us a power, authority, encouragement, a courage, a boldness to overcome the enemy. And he could make it possible. His presence is so supernatural, and you want to experience this evening, come back to God, and he is asking you to submit yourself to him. Obey his voice. He wants to change your life. And he wants to ignite that fire, ignite that things that are there in your life. You have given something to the Lord. Lord, I want to change my life. And he wants to take it as an offering acceptable unto his sight. And let's turn to Matthew's Gospel, chapter 17, verse 2. Finally, when we come back in the sixthly, we understand in the life of Jesus. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 17, verse number 2. And we find it here, Jesus taking the disciples to the Mount of Transfiguration. And after 6 days, Jesus talked Peter, James, and John, his brother, and bringeth them up into a high mountain apart, and was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as a sun, and his raiment was like white as the light. Here we see the flaming power of his presence, the eternal true God, the Almighty God, Jesus Christ, who have come down in the human flesh to con himself the human body, and he showed himself that he is what he is, and his face began to shine as a sun, and the disciples were amazed. And he wants you and I to experience that love shining forth in the brilliance of that glory through our lives. He wants us to experience that love. In Revelation we find chapter 1 verse 13 to 17, and also in chapter 10 verse 1, where we find a man's face was shining like a sun. Jesus' face was shining like a sun. His presence is supernatural. He wants to shine through our lives. Number one, in the Garden of Eden, we find the sinful nature of a man, and he has delivered him. And we find the healing process in the life of Abraham. And we find the greater blessing in the life of Isaac. We find the fourth stage where we see the power given to overcome the enemy. The fifth stage where we see the igniting power. And the sixth stage where Jesus Christ face shining through. The six stages of human life, your spiritual life, need to start on one by one. Which stage are you right now? Are you in the Garden of Eden stage? Are you in the Garden of Eden? Are you in sick? Are you in the sin nature? Are you being stuck with hiding under the trees? You need to be released out of that particular thing. You need to come back to the second level of our understanding, that you need to have that healing and life flowing through your life. Are you released it? Or are you in the third stage of experiencing God's divine power of favor, blessings flowing through you? Yes. Which stage are you right now? The fourth stage where you're fighting with, resisting the enemy, fighting. Oh, day and night we are fighting, wrestling against the devil. Are we doing that? Jacob wrestled the whole night and early morning. He said, unless you bless me, I'm not going to leave you. Is it that the greater challenge you are taking right now? Lord, unless you bless me, I'm not going to leave. I'm going to wrestle. I'm going to wait upon your blessing. I'm going to resist the devil. I'm going to resist it completely. It's going to run away. That's what in James it says. Where are we standing on? Are you standing on to the next level of igniting fire? bringing praises and glory to God from your bottom of your heart, where God is accepting your sacrifice of praises, or Jesus has been revealed through our life. God wants to reveal through us as a living letters for Him. Jesus wants us to be as a living letters. In Ephesians chapter 1 verse 18 says that we are being called to the riches of glory. The word riches is also talks about the wealth of His glory. God's divine glory has been given to us. It is our opportunity and blessing that we need to claim back. In Ephesians chapter 1 verse 19 also reminds of His resurrection power. Colossians chapter 2 verse 9 and 10. All things were made for Him that He can fulfill in through us. That we submit ourselves to Him. We are complete in Him. You are complete in Him. You are complete in Him. It's an opportunity for us to come back and say, I am complete in you. You are working through me. I am so much blessed. Coming back to Exodus chapter 29 verse 43. By His glory He has been showing forth for sanctification. He wants to work through you. His presence need to come back through us. He need to sanctify us. He need to give us that divine power. He is cloud. The cloud came down to the tabernacle and it began to talk. Moses began to talk. Let's turn to Exodus. Exodus chapter 33. Exodus chapter 33, verse number 9. Exodus chapter 33. Turn with me your Bibles. And we understand wherein the angel of the Lord and His presence, we have been understanding here. Exodus chapter 33. Verse number 7 onwards, where it came in verse number 8. And it came to pass when Moses went out of the tabernacle that all the people rose up and stood every man of his tent door and looked after Moses until he was gone into the tabernacle. And it came to pass Moses entered into the tabernacle, a cloudy pillar descended and stood at the door of the tabernacle, and the Lord talked with Moses. When his presence descended, He began to talk to us. This evening, right now, God wants to talk to you. He wants to move through us. He wants to walk through us. This is the right opportunity for you. When you come back to Him with an open heart and mind, Lord, I want Your presence to come down. And He's going to talk to you. He's going to talk to you after the message, after the service. You spend some time in the presence of the Lord. Spend some time, and He wants to talk to you and challenge you. It is your opportunity and our challenge that we need to come back to Him. Verse number 14. And He said, My presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. His presence is going to go along with us. His presence is going to go along with us. What a glorious God He is. His presence is always willing. He is willing to work through us and make our lives transformed, change. His glorious presence that made changes from the Garden of Eden, in the life of Abraham, in the life of Isaac, in the life of Joshua, in the life of Gideon, in the life of Jesus, wherein we see His presence dwelling in us. And the Holy Spirit of God is there in us. We need to give an opportunity for the Spirit of God to work through us. And He wants to touch our lives and change our lives. May we look unto the Lord and ask the Lord to work through us, that His presence may be with us. And during this time of situation where we have been very much afraid and very much shaken, but God is saying, My presence is with you. There is nothing to worry. And I am going to be with you. When God's presence is there, oh, His glory is there. In all the things that are there, God is a consuming fire. He burns everything in and out. And He's going to remove us, those things that are unclean. My dear friend, the Lord. And this is an opportunity for you as you look and listen to this. And you have been brought here. And this is your time. And we want you to strengthen. He wants you to strengthen and come back to Him. Let's close our eyes, bow down our heads, and look unto the Lord and say, Lord, I want You to work through me. I want Your presence that I can know that I can have that healing power, that I can have that divine power of strength and courage, that I can have that blessings flowing through me, that I can have that fire ignited in my life. There are some sacrifice make unto you. Lord, I want you to work through me. Yes. Oh God, thank you, Jesus, Father, Lord. Yes, this is your time. God has been talking to you, speaking to you, and asking you to change your life. Come back to Him. And you have some heaviness in your heart, and you have something that is working in your mind, and it's moving on. Surrender unto Him. Lay it in the altar of Jesus. And He's going to work on, accept it. And He's going to change, transform. And God wants your mind to be transformed. Yes. Maybe ask the Lord, Lord, I want you to work for me. Lord, I want you to strengthen me. Lord, I want you to connect with me. Jesus, Father, Lord. That fire need to be burnt in through my life. The life of Jesus need to shine through me as a living letters. Wherever I go, whatever I do, Lord, people can understand the love of Jesus through my life. May we come back to Jesus. Looking at the cross of Calvary, He has given His life for you. He has sacrificed and given completely for you. What are you giving in return to Him? He wants you to change completely like Him. Oh, He is a glorious God shining forth with greater love, of brilliance, of beauty in Him. He has just given up everything for you, and He wants you to change. Come back to the cross of Calvary. Bow down before Him and ask, Lord, I want Your strength, Your presence to shine through my life. And He's going to work through you, my dear friend. He wants you to come back to Him. I can see that. Yes. Thank you, Lord. You surrender yourself to Him. Just your heart is required. Your mind is required. Nothing else He needs from you. It is your heart and mind. And He wants you to connect to Him and exhibit His love. And His power is going to work through His love. You want His power to work through you. It is His love that is working through you this evening. Yes, this is your opportunity, my dear friend. In the Lord, you are so much wonderful. Thank you. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we want You to strengthen the dear ones who have been talking to You. Lord, give them that courage, boldness, that they can look unto You for Your presence more and more. That You work through them, that Your fire burn in situations. That divine purification will be done. Thank You, Lord. Let Your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Bless you.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you, Reverend Dr. Peter Paul Shetty, for bringing to us the Word of God. Yes, the God is omnipresent, present. His presence is with us now as we worship God within the four walls of our homes, as we come together as church. At this time, let us also thank such kind of times all through this 2000 years of church history. But each time church faced such a difficult situation, it was a time that the church would be strengthened. Church would be strengthened. Let us all bow down our heads where we are and look to God, seeking God's presence to be with us at this time of turmoil, at this time of difficult situations, at this time where the whole world is in panic, when the whole world is looking for help. Our God is omnipresent God, omnipotent God. He is capable of bringing us through these difficult times. Let us look to God in prayer. Gracious God, we thank you and praise you, and we acknowledge that you are a creator, you are a wonderful God. You are the omnipresent, omnipotent, and omniscient God. You are with us at all times. We come to you with one accord, seeking your comforting presence as we gather in our homes and worship together as church, the one body of Christ. We look to you, O Lord, our Creator, for your protection, healing, and that you heal us and all the world with your hand. The world which is gripped with panic and fear of this COVID-19. Thank you, God, for giving us this hope in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, in whom we are saved and called to be your people. At this time, as church, enable us to be your called out people, to show your love and comfort to our neighbors and to each other. At this time, strengthen us to be strong and be resilient and to come back to normalcy as church. Help us to be strong. Bless our families and protect us under your mighty wings, O Lord. We pray for all those who are worshiping with us now, all the individuals and families, and we believe that your presence is with each one of us now. We pray for those dear ones who are celebrating their birthdays, who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries. Give them joy, fill their hearts with gratitude towards you, so that they will celebrate your wonderful blessings in their lives. We remember the sick and the needy. We also remember our church leaders. We also remember the worships that are going across the globe. We also remember the worships that happened today in our branch churches. Gracious Lord, we commit each of ourselves into your mighty hands, that you protect us and guide us at this time when we don't know what decisions to make. Gracious God, give us wisdom, strengthen each one of us. We commit all the families, all the individuals as church into our mighty hands. We pray this in the name of the one who saved us, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. May the blessing of the Lord be with us, the comforting presence of the Savior, and the wonderful presence of the Healer, Jesus Christ, be with us, each one of us, now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you all. May the peace of the Lord be with you.